me now. Come with me now.
Good morning, Wolfpack. I'm Chris Gordon.
And I'm Haley Jong. Today is Tuesday, January 31st, and we're here with your morning announcements. Tomorrow, the library will be having their second annual Guess the Kisses contest. For students or staff that guess closest to the number of the Hershey Kisses in the jar will win a goodie bag. And don't forget to stop by the library to see some new books on display.
And if you wanted to make Valentine cards for children in the hospital, there will be opportunities at lunch today, tomorrow, or Thursday in the cafeteria. So far, 151 Valentines have been made for children in the hospital. Our school goal is 1,000, and we know we can do it.
Attention all students wanting a career in the medical field. Medical students from California North State University will be meeting in Mrs. Wilson's room, HP3, this Wednesday from 3:20 to 4 o'clock to discuss how to get into medical school and advice for anyone wanting to enter the medical field.
Sophomores, if you're interested in taking a push next year, you're asked to attend one of the informational meetings the first week of February. They will be held in HN6 tomorrow at 8:30 and 3:20, or Thursday, February 2nd at 3:20.
And attention juniors interested in registering for AP Government. If you missed last week's AP Info Night or want to know more, then attend any one of Mrs. Lalonde's student info meetings this week. Meetings will be held in HN7 today at 3:20 p.m. and Thursday at 7:30 a.m. and 3:20 p.m.
Let's check in with Antone and Caleb for your sports announcement.
What's up, Wolfpack? I'm Caleb Tabor.
And I'm Antone Cruz. Let's get right into your sports update.
The athletic clearance nights for spring sports are tomorrow and Thursday. Make sure you have physicals and athletic clearance packets filled out.
Speaking of spring sports, let's check out our COHS swim team.
Hello, Wolfpack. I'm Jordan Corder, and today I'm here with Coach Sarah to talk about her expectations for the upcoming swim season.
Expectations of the season are that everybody give it their best shot. Swimmers have to be determined, they have to be hardworking, and they most definitely have to be fearless.
Many swimmers this season are very excited for the upcoming season. I'm here with two such people to talk about their goals.
Hi, I'm Brady Gomez, and my goal this year is to make sections, meet some new people, and make some friends.
Hi, my name is Armand. I'm a sophomore. My goal this season is to improve my freestyle times and to make long-lasting friendships.
Reporting for Wolfpack TV with filmographers Audra Fallon and Carly Johnson, I'm Jordan Corder. Back to you, anchors.
Starting off with the wrestling, the Wolfpack went up to Whitney for a dual meet last Wednesday, and Brian Knoll had an amazing performance, beating one of the top wrestlers in our league in the 126-pound weight class. Let's check out some highlights.
First up, we got some kind of arm bar. I don't know what that is, but that looks real painful.
Then we have a reversal for 2 points.
And another reversal for 2 points. He would go on to pick up the victory.
Our JV wrestlers went to Elk Grove for the John Zinder Tournament. Whitney Crawford and Brian Null took first place, and our very own Rochelle Estrella took third, including Matthew Swanson, Jonah Ruiz. Great wrestling, Wolfpack.
Now on to soccer. Our varsity men's soccer team snapped out of a winless streak with a dominant victory over Del Campo, shutting out the Cougars 7-0. Their next game is tomorrow against Antelope.
Our varsity women's soccer team plays today against Del Campo in an away game. Good luck, ladies.
On to basketball. Our men's varsity team blew out the Oakmont Vikings by 30 points. Their next game is against Del Campo tomorrow.
Again? That was horrible. The women's varsity basketball team also blew out Oakmont again, this time by 43 points. They're now ranked 18th in the region by the Sacramento Bee.
That's it for your sports update, Wolfpack. I'm Antone Cruz.
And I'm Caleb Taker. Stay smooth, Wolfpack.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. Hype Showcase is coming up February 3rd and 4th. Tickets are $8 presale and $10 at the door. You can purchase them at the student store.
And if you're interested in joining Hype next year, audition packets can be found in the dance room or in student services.
Speaking of which, VAPA auditions for students who are interested in joining vocal ensemble, jazz ensemble for advanced children's theater are tomorrow the 31st and February 2nd in the choir room from 3:30 to 5:30.
And if you're not done signing up for all these clubs and organizations yet, leadership applications are now out and due February 2nd. You can print them from School Loop or get them from the activities room in front of the MP. You do not need prior leadership experience to join.
Key Clubbers, elections will be happening on February 7th and 14th. If you're running, please hand in your service agreement to an officer and email your literature to them by this Friday.
Attention all students, there will be a food fair this Friday during both lunches. Make sure to check out the lists that are posted around school. Well, that's all we have for you today. I'm Chris Gordon.
And I'm Haley Jong. Remember, the strength of the pack is the wolf.
And the strength of the wolf is the pack.
Happy National Hot Chocolate Day.
Theodosia writes me a letter every day. I'm keeping her bed warm while her husband is away. He's on the British side in Georgia. He's trying to keep the colonies in line. Well, he can keep all of Georgia. Theodosia, she's mine. Love doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes and it takes and it takes, and we keep loving.